we don't have the technology to pick it up doesn't mean it isn't there. Okay? Number 12, rediscovery that each of us is a part of the whole of the universe, and we are a significant part of that idea that we call God, and that God is the idea called love. Number 13, that this accelerating self-discovery being experienced was created and activated by all of us. So, well, sir, that's a $64,000 question. If you get that answer, will you call me and let me know? When I look at history and I look at where we are today, there's a history of history repeating itself. And, you know, it's like a hamster that climbs on the wheel. No matter how fast he goes, as long as he stays on that wheel, he's not going anywhere. So maybe we just needed to make a change. You know, maybe we're all sick and tired of this. You know, maybe we need like a vacation. My understanding, sir, is that they are different. Your consciousness is completely different. And this is important. There is a physicality on all dimensions. Okay? Because there's a physicality. It's different from us. For example, fifth density, we live in a color spectrum of 72 colors or light frequencies. Fifth density is 214. That's a major shift. That's a major shift. Number 14, that we as a product of extraterrestrial genetic manipulations are possessors of a vast gene pool that has many different racial memory banks of at least 22 extraterrestrial races in our DNA. Many different racial memory banks. That means that when things get a little bit higher, our kids, you're going to start knowing things that you don't have any idea how you know, but you do know it. You will know languages that haven't been spoken on this planet for thousands and thousands of years. You will just know because it's inside of us. We're a library. You know, Barbara Marciniak, her piece, they talk about this as well. And I think some of the other groups do. Because of our genetic heritage, we are considered royalty. We need to acknowledge it, acknowledge ourselves, and seize our genetic heritage. Now, I'm going to end on this. I was having a... Actually, I'm going to end on two things. I was having a particularly bad month. Personal relationships and just everything else. And it was time for me to come back here. I was living in Lake Arrowhead at the time, which is in Southern California. And I didn't want to come back. I flat just did not want to come back. So I got really upset. I started to cry, and I didn't want to come back. And as I found myself on the ground again, I remember I heard Visayas' voice in the back of my head. He said, turn around. I turned around, and he was at the door of the craft as it was starting to take off. And he looked at me, and he said, Alex, the love that you withhold is the pain that you carry lifetime after lifetime. And I just want to pass that on to you. Because nothing else that they have said has changed me more significantly than that. Yes, the love that you withhold is the pain that you carry lifetime after lifetime.
With that thought, colleagues, you disturbed me a while ago. You said you didn't have an end, and yet you just define your end. What gave you the idea that you did not have an end?
It's a belief in oneself, sir. I think that's what it is. It's a belief in oneself.
A belief in the God.
Yeah. But we'll talk about that. We'll talk about that. I'm trying not to give all of myself away here. Hold on. I want to end up with this. I'm done with this.
Squeaking and squawking.
I once asked. I once asked Paseas.
Wrong microphone.
I once asked Paseas.
Put that one up.
I once asked Paseas, okay, what was our future going to be? You know, the future of us here on Earth. And this was his response. This is the Andromedan definition of our future, us as a race. Responsible freedom of self-determination. Becoming truly self-confident and free to unconditionally be responsible for oneself without being coerced to accept some higher authority. I want to read it one more time. Responsible freedom of self-determination. Okay. Folks, thank you for coming. Becoming truly self-confident and free to unconditionally be responsible for oneself without being coerced to accept some higher authority. Ladies and gentlemen, you're awesome. Don't let anybody tell you different. Go out there and kick ass. Thank you.
About this. When Alex and Carla came, I don't